As they always ask in Washington, does he have the votes?
Doesn't look like they do at this point. Manchin was interviewed on a MSNBC show, Morning Joe, but before he did that, an NBC reporter said he told her privately, "We will not get the votes today," and she posted this on Twitter. But then he kind of backtracked on it when he went on the air later. But right now, it looks like they are short of the votes.
How many?
Well, it's hard to tell. Vice President Biden said yesterday they were a couple votes short. I think that's probably accurate. The thing is that it really, in one sense, it doesn't matter. If they are short, they need to get to 60 votes to pass the Manchin-Toomey proposal, okay? If they're short and they know it going into the vote, that kind of frees up senators who might have voted yes to vote no if they feel like it. So it's you can't say that they were, you know, I mean, we could end up with 51 or 52 votes for this, but it was really 58. But then because of the way votes happen,
right,
they could be freed up and they could say, well, it's not going to pass. I'm going to vote
against it. Yeah, I'm going to vote against it, but yeah, exactly.
Right, exactly. It's kind of a free vote for them. But it all, that's all kind of the logistics of how the vote unfolds. But it's clear right now they don't have the vote.
You surprised?
Not really. I mean, it was always going to be a tough vote. It was clear by early in the week. It was clear by Monday. At one point Monday, they thought they were going to get it, but it was clear to us and the reporting that we did that Republicans, they've only gotten probably 4 Republican votes. They've gotten Toomey. They've got Senator Susan Collins of Maine. They've gotten Senator Mark Kirk of Illinois and probably John McCain of Arizona. With only 4 votes and 55 Senate Democrats, they can see to 59. And then there's some Senate Democrats who don't want this, especially folks who are up in red states in 2014. So it was always going to be a hard vote. President Obama and Vice President Biden have been working this. The gun control groups have been working this. Mayors Against Illegal Guns, the Brady Campaign for Prevention of Gun Violence, they've been working it. But the NRA has been working it hard as well. And this is some tough votes for Democrats who are up for re-election in 2014. And the biggest races for them are in Western states, red states where there is a history of gun culture. So it was always going to be a very difficult vote for them. And so, I mean, it's not shocking. I mean, the big question now becomes, what do they do next? There's going to be a series of votes today. Manchin-Toomey will be one of them, but there'll be a series of votes. There'll be several Republicans, several Democratic. The Republicans are actually pushing votes to expand gun rights, to expand concealed carry permits, the ability of folks with concealed carry permits to carry their guns in other states. I mean, if any of the Republican amendments pass, that could be this could turn into, yeah, they lost on Manchin-Toomey, but it could turn into a disaster for Democrats. I mean, they're taking a gamble by even going to this vote. So the whole question is, if nothing passes and we're back where we started, what will the Democrats do? Did they take this issue to say, look, we're going to run on this in 2014? Do they try to go back to committee and rework the bill to see if they can pull some more Republicans? I mean, there's a lot of different. It's very fluid right now, but it seems, I mean, the clearest thing we can say right now is heading into the vote at 4 p.m., so 6 hours from now, Manchin-Toomey does not look like it's going to pass.
John Bresnahan is with us, and he's a congressional correspondent for Politico. He writes about it today. Senate is going to vote on the gun control measure later today, the Manchin-Toomey amendment. I know one of the things that Manchin was trying to get in his discussions leading up to this was he was trying to get something the NRA would not necessarily endorse, but they just wouldn't fight. And if he got that, if he sort of got a silence from the NRA, he probably could have gotten this through. So obviously he did not get that.
No, he wanted the NRA to stay neutral, and we actually reported that was, he was saying, look, going to the NRA, who he's had a good relationship with.
Yeah.
I mean, this is a guy who's an A rating from the NRA on gun issues. Somebody who's had a long relationship with them. He went to them and said, look, exactly as you said, okay, maybe you don't support it, but don't oppose it. If you guys are neutral, we can pass anything. But the NRA came out and said very strongly that, we are opposed to the Manchin-Toomey proposal. It leads, it's an opening chapter in a national gun registry, or the idea that there'll be a federal national gun registry that the government will be able to know if you have a gun, the federal government. They came out very strongly against it. There were some Republicans who were on the fence, for instance, Dean Heller of Nevada, that was someone who was considered on the fence, and he came out and said no last night. Other Republicans have come out over the last week. So it was very clear by Monday and totally, you know, blatantly clear yesterday. They didn't have the votes. I mean, Manchin can put it, you know, he can put a good face on it, but right now they don't have the votes. But I do, even if it doesn't pass, though, there are a lot of Democrats who praise Manchin, though. They were surprised that it even got this far, frankly, that they were able to get it to the point where they could have a vote on it. Now, whether you're opposed or supportive of it, I mean, you know, if you're a West Virginian, you know, Joe Manchin showed, for a relatively new senator, he showed some serious savvy getting it this far, you know. And again, you may not like the bill, but, you know, here's a guy who is a rookie in Senate terms. And he got it. He got an agreement with Toomey. He's going to get a vote on it. It's probably going to fail, but you know, he showed some savvy in getting it this far. So, you know, and then we have to figure out, you know, what is the Senate going to do next,
John? You know, and on that, on Manchin, and we've talked about this a lot. Yeah. Look, there's no question that Manchin has political skills. I mean, he has political skills. Yeah. We've seen him in West Virginia.
You were saying this the other day.
Right? Yeah. But also, this cuts two ways in West Virginia. On one hand, there are a lot of West Virginians who, like the polls reflect, say, yeah, expanded background checks, that seems reasonable, and are not bothered by that. They're okay with that. Then there's another, as you know, this is a very strong gun rights state, and there's a portion of the population, which I have heard from extensively in emails and phone calls, that say, look, here's a guy who had an A rating from the NRA, who famously shot the cap and trade bill with a rifle, and he goes to Washington, and then he's the one guy who actually has a chance of passing gun control. So some people are really, now I'm not sure if they were Manchin supporters, but some people are really outraged by that. So it's a split decision for him in West Virginia on that part, I think.
Clearly, right. I do think Manchin, listen, I do think on a personal level, and you have to remember, you know, we cover these guys as, you know, men and women of the Senate and politicians as you know, as issues, as people who make headlines, but they are actually human beings. I do think Manchin, on a very personal level, was shocked by what happened at Newtown. Mm-hmm. Absolutely shocked, as the rest of the country was, at a very personal level, and felt that there had to be a response. Now, you may not agree with his response, but I think, as the everybody, where no matter where you stand on gun rights issues, everyone was just stunned and shocked and horrified. And I think, as was Pat Toomey, and they thought, you know, look, if we can do something, let's try something. And the Manchin will also argue very, and he's a very persuasive argument, this bill in some ways helps on gun rights. It expands, you know, on interstate gun sales, on those kind of issues. This is a bill that the liberals hate. They don't like this bill. Now, they'd swallow it, but they don't like this bill because it actually, in some cases, expands gun rights. So, you know, this was you have to give Manchin some credit. You can oppose it or not, but you also have to remember, he is a human being. All these folks are men and women. They're a human being. They're fathers, their mothers, you know, grandparents. They saw what happened. They reacted viscerally, as did the entire country.
Follow along today, not only with us, but of course with Politico and John Bresnahan, senior congressional reporter for Politico. John, thanks for your insights. We appreciate it.